In today's video, I am going to explain the problem using Stirling's formulae. So this is the Stirling's formulae, and we have to apply Stirling's formulae to find the polynomial of degree 4. These are the x values, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and y values are 1, minus 1, 1, minus 1 and 1. So the difference table here is, so these are the x values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and these are the y values, that is 1, minus 1, 1, minus 1, 1. So we have to create this reference table. First of all, while creating, this is minus 1 minus 1. So this will be minus 2. 1 minus of minus plus. So this will be plus 2. Minus 1 minus 1. So this is minus 2. And 1 minus of minus plus 2. And the next one is 1 minus of minus 2. This is 4. This is minus 2 minus 2. So this value is minus 4. This is 2 plus 2. The value here is 4. Minus 4 minus 4, the value here is minus 8. This is 4 plus 4, the value here is 8. This is 8 minus of minus, this value is 16. So here we have to take, so we have to take x naught value as 3. So if you select x naught value as 3, so we have to find the polynomial. So this will be x naught. If it's x naught, the corresponding y value will be y naught. And these are the values required. So if it's y naught, see here. So if the value is y naught here, so this will be obviously y minus 1. So this is y minus 2. And this is y1 and this is y2. So these are the first reference values, that is delta y. So first of all, there is minus 2 here. We have to keep on writing from minus 2. So this is minus 1, 0, 1. And the next one, these are the second difference values. So delta square y. So this is delta square y. So we have to start with minus 2. So this is minus 2, minus 1, 0. And these are the third difference values. So these are the third difference values. We have to start with minus 2. This is minus 1. This is delta power 4. This is minus 2. So these are all the values needed. So first of all, we have to take this as y naught and double. This value is single, this value is double, and this value is single. So we need all these values here. So first of all, we have a formula that x is equal to, that is x naught plus p into h. So what is h value? So h is the difference between this, that is 5 minus 4, the value here is 1. So if I substitute the same thing, x is equal to, this is 3 plus p into 1. So what is our p value? That is, this is x minus 3. So now we have to substitute all these values in the Stirling's formulae. So we have a Stirling's formulae ready here. So according to the Stirling's formulae, we have yp is equal to, this is y naught plus p times of, this is delta y naught plus delta y minus 1 by 2 plus, this value is p square by 2 into delta square y minus 1. This is p into, this is p square minus 1 by 3 factorial into, this is delta cube y minus 1, and this is delta cube y minus 2 by 2, and plus this will be p square into p square minus 1 by 4 factorial into delta power 4 y minus 2 plus, and so on. So we have to put all these values here, and we need the polynomial. So here p value is equal to x minus 3. I'll substitute the same thing here, that is yp is equal to, what is y naught? See, I'll show you the y naught value is 1. So this is 1 plus, what is our p value? P value is nothing but x minus 3 into delta y naught plus delta y minus 1. So this is minus 2 plus 2. See here, this is minus 2 plus 2 divided by 2. Next one, p square, that is x minus 3 whole square by 2 into delta square y minus 1. The next value here is minus 4. So this value is minus 4. And the next one, p value is nothing but x minus 3. So this is x minus 3 into, this is x minus 3 whole square minus 1 by 3 factorial, it is nothing but 6. This is delta cube. See here, the delta cube y minus 1, delta cube y minus 2. That is 8 minus 8. 8 minus 8 by 2. plus this one is p square, that is x minus 3 whole square into this is x minus 3 whole square minus 1 by 4 factorial, 1 into 2 into 3 into 4, which is nothing but 24 into delta power 4 y minus 2, which is equal to 16. So this value is 16. If you observe properly, so this is minus 2 and plus 2, 0. This is plus 8 and minus 8, 0. This whole thing will be 0. This will be what remains, x is equal to, this is 1. This value is 0. So I'm writing this as 0. This is x minus 3 whole square by 2 into this value is minus 4. See here, the value here is minus 4. And this one is 0. So this value will be, this is x minus 3 whole square into this is x minus 3 whole square minus 1 by 24 into 16. So this will be, if I cancel in 8 table, this is 16, 8 2s and 8 3s. And this in 2 times. So what remains here? So YP value will be, this is 1 plus x minus 3 whole square into minus 2, and this is 2 by 3 times of, this is x minus 3 whole square, this is x minus 3 whole square minus 1. So now we have to calculate the polynomial, that is 1, this is minus 2 times of, if I expand, this will be a square plus b square minus 2ab. So if I expand this one, so this will be a square plus b square minus 2ab, and see here in brackets, that is x square, a square plus b square minus 2ab minus 1. See here, so this will be, yp value will be 1 minus, so if you multiply with 2, this is 2x square plus 18 minus this is 12x plus this is 2 by 3 of, this is x square plus 9 minus 6x. So if I multiply, this is x square minus 6x, this is 9 minus 1. So how much it is? 8. So this value is 8. Now yp is equal to, this is 1 minus, this is 2x square plus 18 minus 12x, this is 2 by 3 times of, if I multiply, see what happens, this will be x power 4 minus 6x cube plus 8x square plus 9x square minus 54x plus 8 9s are, sorry, 9 8s are, this is 72 minus 6x cube plus this is 36x square minus this is 48x. Let me see once again. This is x power 4 minus 6x cube plus 8x square. So this is 9x square minus 54x. This is a 72 minus 6x cube minus of minus plus is 36x square minus 48x. So see here, yp is equal to 1 minus, this is 2x square plus 18 minus 12x plus 2 by 3 times of, this is x power 4. So if you observe, 6 cube for, this is minus 6 minus 6, this is 12x cube, and the next one square here, so this is a 17 plus 36. So see here, this is 8 plus 9 plus 36, this will be 53. So this is 53x square, and the next one here is x terms, minus 54 minus 48. This is 54 plus 48. The value here is 102 minus 102x, and what remained here, this is plus 72. This is plus 72. And the next one, if I take 3 as LCM, so 1 by 3 if I take as LCM here, so this will be 3, this is minus 3 times of, this is 2x square plus 18 minus 12x, and if I multiply with 2, this will be 2x power 4 minus 24x cube plus, so this is 6, 106x square, and this is 204x plus, see here, everything is correct. This is 144. This is 144. So if I still multiply, this is 1 by 3 times of this is 3. So if I multiply, this is minus 6x square. This is minus 54. This is 54 minus of minus plus 36x plus 2x power 4 minus 24x cube plus 106x square minus 204x plus 144 plus 144. See here, yp value will be 1 by 3 times of, first of all, this is the single 2x power 4. So this is 2x power 4. So if you look at x cube values, so this is x cube. See here, this will be minus 24x cube, and see x square terms. So there is x square here, square, and that's it. That is 106. This is 106 minus 6. The value here is 100. This is plus 100x square. And the next value here, if you observe x values, so this is 36, this is 104, that's it. That is 36 minus, this is 104. This is minus 168. This is minus 168x. And the next term are the constants. So here, if you observe this one, so which values we have to take? So this is 3. This is 144. This is 3. 3 minus 54 plus 144. The value here is 93 plus 93. So this is the polynomial. C. This is 2x power 4 minus 24x cube. This is 100x square. 168x. Plus this value is 93. So if you go through this one, this is 2x power 4, this is minus 24x cube, and this is 100x square, and this value, that is x square, it is correct. So this is 36 minus, so 36 minus 204. So the 36 minus 204 is again minus 168, and the constants are 3 here, 3 plus 144. So the constant value is 3 plus 144, that is 147. See here, did I miss anything? Minus 54. So this is 93. So this is how we have to solve. This is the polynomial. This is nothing but the Stirling's polynomial. This is the polynomial. So this is how we have to solve. Using the Stirling's formula, we have to substitute each and every value, and we have to keep on multiplying, and that the final answer, it is the polynomial of degree 4. Thank you so much for watching and staying till the end. I'll be uploading the next topic, and please have a look at those. If you really like, please subscribe. Share it with your friends and leave a comment below.